Hey guys, today we're going to be giving you some tips and tricks on breeding Chahoua geckos. Chahoua geckos are not like any other new Caledonian gecko. They require a lot more attention when breeding. I actually find that Chahoua are a lot more aggressive than even Lichianus when breeding, way more than gargoyles or even crested geckos. So with them, what you need to do is actually check on them every day. And that means that no matter what, you have to have a pair of eyes on them. You can't go a day without looking at them, because the thing with Chahoua is when they snap, they fight to the death. Yes, that is the case with Lichianus as well. However, what I find is that Lichianus are actually more calm and they're willing to tolerate their current tank mate even if they don't bond with them. But with Chahoua specifically, they will fight to the death, and there have been some crazy photos posted online of the repercussions of not watching your animals. When breeding Chahoua, there's a big thing that you need to watch out for, and it's calcium crashes. Chahoua have highly calcified eggs, and it goes, like, the female goes through so much when producing these eggs, and when she hatches, you actually notice that their heads sink in, they get very skinny, their tails get all wavy, and if you don't watch this and you don't spike their food with calcium, you will have a gecko with metabolic bone disease. So what I recommend having is actually keeping a liquid calcium container to treat your females after every single lay. This is what I do, and I always have successfully calcified eggs, and my females are very healthy. So this liquid calcium was actually provided to me by Stargazer Exotics, and they provided a coupon code for you guys as well, which is SGRE, and you get 20% off everything on their website. And I know a few of you had said that you had issues with shipping and they only provide a greyhound. Just make sure you just collect choose other method and they would be able to ship anywhere. But be sure to get your hands on liquid calcium or the Repashi Calcium Plus to ensure that your geckos remain healthy. What I like to do with Chahoua, and I've actually noticed them lapping it up, is I actually put a little dish in their tanks with calcium in it, and they'll go to it periodically and actually lick it up. And this is great because then it keeps them nice and healthy, it keeps them away from metabolic bone disease, and yeah. Another thing you need to do is provide them with UV lights. I personally find that they benefit from UV lights over any other New Caledonian species. I know I've said this before and it helps crested geckos fire up and everything. However, for Chahoua, because of all the vitamins and all of the calcium they use to actually produce their eggs, it is imperative that you give them UV. This helps them absorb the calcium that they're intaking in their food, and they're not just going to expel it with their poop. So provide them with UV lights and provide them with a heat source as well. What the heat source does is it helps increase their metabolism, and this helps them absorb their calcium as well. And you'll notice that with Chahoua, at least if you provide them with the UV and with the heat source, they're going to choose one or the other. They're going to bask underneath the UV bulb, or they're going to be sitting right on top of the heat mat. A good way to tell if a female is preparing to lay is if she stays near your heat source. So I have a heat mat on all of my Chahoua cages, and this female was paired with Winston here, and ever since she's been paired, she's always been on this heat mat, so that tells me she's developing eggs. A good way to tell if your female is actually gravid or not is to notice their patterns. I find that anytime a female is resting near a heat source, not underneath the UV particularly, but when I have a heat pad, if they go and they sleep on it every single night and it's out in the open no matter what, I find that they're developing their eggs in their stomachs. So that means that you have a successful pair, in my opinion. And typically, within 30 to 45 days of initial copulation, you'll see some eggs. However, with Chahoua, it's not really easy to determine when they're going to lay. I know that with crested geckos, every 30 days, 40 days, they are laying no matter what. But Chahoua is a waiting game. And they can produce eggs now and then produce eggs in 3 months. Or they can produce eggs now and not produce eggs for another year. And that's what kind of makes it imperative to have a heat source, to have this UV, because I find that they don't actually produce their eggs if they don't have enough calcium in their system. They'll actually reabsorb their eggs. I know this isn't scientifically proven, but I've noticed that females that I don't provide a heat source to in the past are the ones that take the longest to actually develop eggs and to lay them. And the ones that do have a heat source are the ones that have more of a scheduled laying schedule, which is typically between 45 and 60 days. With Chahoua geckos, what you need to do is make sure you keep an eye on them. When you pair them, it's not like Lichianus. Yes, you can do like the Lichianus and take out a piece of cork from one cage, put it into the other, make sure that they get used to each other's scent. However, what I like to do is I actually like to take them into a different container and introduce themselves within, you know, 2 weeks before the actual introduction, just so that they get used to each other's scent. You'll be there to watch them, you'll make sure that they won't fight to the death, and you just see how they react. Typically, you'll start to notice that the male's tail will start to shake. You'll start noticing how the female actually reacts to this. She's either gonna react positively or negatively. I find that they'll attack out the gate if they don't like the male. But keep in mind that no matter what, as I said before, you're going to have to watch them all the time. And they might be perfect in the beginning. They might be a pair that's been producing for years. But one day they can just snap and you'll have a gecko with half of its face hanging off. And that's what you want to try to avoid. Mainly because if you catch it on the first day, yes, you're still going to catch them with a face that is battered and bruised and cut. But if you leave them in the cage, that other gecko is going to continue to bully them. They're going to continue to fight and they will fight to the death. So it is imperative that you constantly have eyes on these geckos. They are not like a crested gecko. They are not like a gargoyle gecko. You have to watch them all the time, specifically for their minerals, for their calcium intake, as well as while they're breeding, or else you will lose an animal very, very easily. So that's all I have for you today. I hope you like it. I'm gonna take out some geckos for you now, just so you can take a look so you don't get my ugly mug. Let's see. So here's a mainland male that I got here. Seen my white collar. She's hidden in there. She made a big mess, and she always makes a big mess. And then you have my original pair with Winston there. That was my look. He is the reason why Reptilege is what it is. Here. She's hanging out on the heat mat right now. Friday is cleaning day, so that's why you're seeing a lot of mess here. Now let me know if you guys want to see how I take care of fruit flies and how I make sure that they don't come back, because I've got a fruit fly problem because these are fruit eaters, and I can show you how I catch them with this particular method. Let me know down in the comments, all right? Thanks.